Hi all,
so welcome to this channel once again, and today in this video we'll discuss this topic, that is if then else if else and end if conditions. Apart from that, we'll also discuss case statement. So basically we'll discuss these things in how we'll be using them in the SQL stored procedures. So let's directly move on to the demo where I created examples to show you all these things. So let me open the first one. So you can see I'm creating a stored procedure here, which is an SQL procedure. So create or replace procedure, and the name of the procedure is this. And it's an specific name that is stored file. So whenever we create a procedure, a program object gets created with the specific name, and it will be unique for all the procedures. So in case a procedure with the same name, for example, let's say this created twice in a same schema, but the specific name must be different. So if you don't provide the specific name, so if it is in 10 characters, it is okay for the name of the stored procedure would be same as the specific name, or you can say the specific name would be same as the name of the procedure, SQL procedure. But in case if it is longer than 10 characters, then that would be assigned from the system side. Now let's move on to these conditions. So this is, you can see, begin and end of the stored procedure block. Now here you can see I declared one variable var1, and I'm setting the value of that variable as set var1 equals to 1. I can also use default here, default space, let's say default value. So if I do not provide the default, its default is null. I can also provide one like this. So anyway, you can do the same thing with this as well, declaration as well. Now I'm setting this variable to 1. You can see how I'm using the if and if else statements. So let me tell you. So if var1 equals to 1, then I'm setting var1 equals to 2 and if. So this way you can see I'm not using semicolon here because it's the start of the if block. So if and then is in the same block, so the end of the block would be from end if. So please ensure that end and if must be separated by a space, else you will be getting the error that this semicolon is not valid. So you can see if and end if block where I'm using then. So if this, then set this and end if block. Now if I'm gonna using the else as well with the if then, so how I'll be doing that. If var1 equals to 2, because I'm setting this to 2 now, then set var1 equals to 3 else. So if var1 is not equals to 2, it would go to the else part and setting var1 equals to 4 and end if. So you can see here every time the block would end at the last with end if only, we would not be closing the block of if or else with the semicolon. These are the statements which are separated by the semicolon because they are independent SQL statements. So for if, else and end if, we will be closing that in the end if, as the same way we did it, this in the if and then and end if block. Now let's suppose if there is if, else if or else or end if as well. So we'll do the same thing. If var1 equals to 3, then set this, else if var1 equals to 4, then this. So you can see in else if we won't be using this space, else this. So in this case as well, you can see I'm enclosing or I'm closing the block of if and if with the semicolon at the last. So you won't be closing here or here. So this must be ensure that whenever we are using these condition, we must enclose the semicolon with the last and if. So this is the basic thing of if and end if block. Let me create the procedure. So for that I'm using run SQL stm command. So here I need to give the source file, here the library name, here the source member name. I can use commit stanan if I'm using commit, if I'm not using commitment control. So here I can use star cag because I'm not doing any SQL operation. If I want, I can debug from here. I can set debug us star source. So now it's compiled. Let me show you the object. Store 5 gets created and it's an program. So I can debug a program. So let me show you the entry of this as well. Select star from qsys2.sysprocs. Let me enter the specific name or the procedure name because both are same. So this was created and this is calling the program this. Now I can call it from here from the command line, call the same way I call a program. So since it's a program, so I can call it like this, or I can call it from the SQL, str/sql. So let me first debug this strdbg stored 5. So after its debug, I'll be discussing the case statement, how we'll be using the case statement in the SQL store procedure. So let's let me finish this first. So I'm waiting for the debug view source. So let's put the breakpoint. Now either I can call it from here or I can call it from str/sql. Call this. So you can see I'm on source since it's in debug mode. Var1 is now set to null because as I earlier told you, so var1 equals to set var1 equals to 1, so now it's 1. After that, let's if condition this, then set var1 equals to 2, so it's again true. If var1 equals to 2, then do this. So it did not went to the else part because this condition, if condition gets satisfied, if var1 equals to 3, yes, so it will go to the var this section and all other sections would not be executed since this is satisfied. So you can see how this executed. Now let's move on to the case statement. So for that I created this stored procedure, stored 6. So same way, it is created using the create or replace procedure and specific name is stored 6. Now here you can see I defined three variables of integer type and all will be default null. Then I am setting var1 equals to 2. Now you can see how I can use case in a different way, in different syntaxes. So first way is a simple case where I am using case then the variable name, so var1, and then I'm using the when blocks. So when and else, and this is the end case. So end case would be separated by a space in between them. And as I told in case of if and if case, so in the same way it is also enclosed last with the semicolon. Now case var1, so I'm checking for the var1 condition. So when 1, so if var1 is 1, then set var2 equals to 1. If var1 is 2, when 2, then set var2 equals to 2. So 2 is basically var1. So if var1 value is 2, then it's set to 2. If 3, then this, else set this. var2 to 0, and this is the end of the case operation. So if in case a first condition gets true, when 1 var1 equals to 1, then it gets executed and all other would get skipped. Even after that, for example, I use here it's greater than 2, var1 is greater than 2, or var1 is greater than 1. In all other conditions, they are all true, but if var1 is greater than 1, but they won't get executed because the first condition on the when block gets executed and others are skipped. So this is the way how this case work. Now I set the var1 and var3 as 1. Now you can see case here I didn't use the var1, so it is more enhanced search way. Now it's not a simple case when var1 plus var2 equals to 1. So I'm checking var1 plus var2 equals to 1 means it's 2 for now, then set this. If when var1 plus var2 equals to 2, then set this. If 3, then set this, else set 0, and end of case. So this way also we can use the case statement. Another way to use it, like case when var1 is greater than 1, where I am checking for the greater or less than conditions. So this is actually same as the first one, where I use the second one. Here I am adding these two and then checking. Here I am simply checking for greater than values. Now we can also include the AND operation with the when and case and when. So you can see when var1 between 1 and 3, then set this. When var1 between 2 and 6, then set this. When var1 between 7 and 9, 10, then set this, and else this. So this way you can use the case block, a case statement in the SQL stored procedure. So let me create this as well. So here I only need to change the source member name. If I do work object stored 6, so you can see its program object gets created. Let me debug this. So just do F9. So here just change the source mem program name. Now set the breakpoint. So the same way we can check its entry as well. So you can see it's present, and its external definition is it's calling this program in this library. Now either I can call it from here, or from I can call it from here as well. So let's call this from here now. Six. You can see I'm in debug mode. So they all are set to null now. Set var1 equals to 2. So case when 1, when 2. So when 2 condition is true, now its val2 becomes when 2, then val2 is 2, and all other conditions are skipped. Now it's end out of end case block. Now again on the second case block, where it's checking var1 plus var2 equals to 1, no, it's 2. So this condition gets satisfied. So var1 is 1 and var2 was 2, so it's 3. So this condition gets satisfied and it's setting var2 as 3 and end of case. Set var1 equals to 2. If var1 is greater than 1, yes, it's true. Set var2 to 1, then again end case. Now var1 set to 3. So if it's 1 and between 1 and 3, it gets true. So var2 becomes 1. So you can see how in these different ways you can just and debug this. So you can use the if then else if block, if then else or end if, else if or else or end if block, and the case statement in your SQL Store procedures. So that's what all here to present in this video. So thank you and have a nice time.